We have always known snake as harmful, poisonous. Is that true? Are all snakes harmful? Well, the answer is no, they are not. And the poem we shall read today is about one such harmless snake. And the name of the poem is The Snake Trying, and it is written by W.W.E. Ross. So now let's read what is W.W.E. Ross trying to convey us through his poem. So now the introduction of the poem. The poet wants to say that all snakes are not harmful. Humans have a notion. Notion means belief. Humans have a belief that snakes are dangerous and try to kill them as soon as they spot one. But this is not true. Like I told you that not all snakes are poisonous. And this is the human nature that whenever they see a snake crossing or a snake in front of them, they kill them immediately because they think that they are poisonous and they can harm anyone. So as soon as they see them, they kill them. So we should not think about it. He tells us how a harmless green colored snake tries to hide behind the green bushes in order to save itself. So ab hame through his poem, he's trying to tell us that In this poem, he's going to talk about a harmless snake who's trying to save himself from a human being. Now, as you can see in the picture, the boy is hitting the snake. The snake trying to pursue, to escape the pursuing stick with sudden curvings of thin, long body. How beautiful and graceful are his shapes. So now, he's saying that the snake is trying to escape the pursuing stick. Pursuing means the stick that is chasing him, the stick that is following him. With sudden curvings of thin, long body. As you can see in the picture, as you all know that snakes, wo seedhe nahi chalte hain, they curve and then they twist and then they walk. So now here the poet is saying that their shapes are so beautiful and graceful. So now this was the explanation of the first stanza that I've already explained to you, that the snake is trying to escape the stick that is following it. He glides through the water away from the stroke. Glides means he moves. Where does he move? He moves in the water, as you can see in the picture. Why is he moving there? Because he is away from the stroke. That means to hide from the hitting of the stick, he has moved into the water. Oh, let him go over the water. Now, the poet is saying this, that please let him go. Where? Over the waters into the reeds. Reeds are the thick water plants that is visible to you in the picture. To hide without hurt. So now the snake was hiding in the thick reeds in the water so that he can be safe from the stick. Small and green, he's harmless even to children. So up, the description of the snake is being given, that he's small and he's green in color and he's harmless. Okay? He's not harmful to anyone. It is harmless even to children. So this is again the explanation in which we have studied that the snake was trying to escape himself and he was going in the marshy plants so that he can be saved from the stick. And now here the poet gave the description that the snake was harmless, it was green in color and it was harmless even to children. Now students, yeah, children kyun bola gaya hai? Agar ek snake ek old person ko kaat de ya fir ek around 40-50 age person ko kaate, to wo fir bhi survive kar lenge. But if a snake bites a child, they don't have that much of stamina to fight over that poison that is being spread in their body. So now here, that is the reason why he is saying ki wo na hi sirf bado ke liye, in fact that is harmless even to children, wo bachcho ko bhi nuksan nahi pahunchega. So now what is the reason to kill it? Jab ek aapko pata hai ek snake hai jo ek poisonous nahi hai, harmful nahi hai, so why do you have to kill that snake? This is what the poet wants to convey. Along the sand he lay until observed. Now the snake was lying in the sand until observed. Matlab jab tak usko kisi ne nahi dekha tha, it was lying in the sand. and chased away, and now he vanishes in the ripples among the green slim reeds. So jab kisi ne use dekh liya snake ko, to where does he vanish? He vanishes in the ripples among the green slim reeds. So again wo jhaadiyon jo water ke wahan jhaadiyan thi, wo wahan jaake chup gaya in order to protect himself when somebody saw him, aur jab wo uske piche chase kar rahe the. Till it was spotted and chased away by the person holding a stick, it lay quietly in the sand. Jab tak kisi ne use dekha nahi tha, tab tak snake was lying quietly in the sand, and as soon as somebody saw him, to wo jaake kahan jaake chup gaya, in the green bushes of the marshy lands. Now see, already the snake was green in color. Agar wo green bushes mein hi jaake chup jata hai, to there are वेरी लिटिल चांसेस कि पीपल उनको ऑब्जर्व करेंगे, क्योंकि वो ग्रीन कलर का स्नेक था एंड वो ग्रीनरी के ही आसपास होगा, तो इट इज़ डिफिकल्ट फॉर पीपल टू स्पॉट दैट स्नेक. सो एज यू ऑल नो मोस्ट इन द मोस्ट ऑफ बाय दिस वी कम टू द एंड ऑफ द पोम. पोम बहुत छोटी थी, वेयर द पोएट वॉज ट्राइंग टू से दैट यू मस्ट नॉट किल स्नेक्स, बिकॉज एनिमल्स आपको तब तक हार्म नहीं करेंगे जब तक आप उन्हें कोई हार्म नहीं करोगे. सो इट्स बेटर दैट वी डोंट हार्म एनी एनिमल, सो दैट इवन दे फील सेफ एंड दे फील फ्री टू वॉक अराउंड. ठीक है, एज यू कैन, हमने जैसे पढ़ा पोम में, दिस स्नेक वॉज ट्राइंग टू एस्केप द परस्यूइंग स्टिक. एक पर्सन उसको मार रहे थे, तो इट वॉज ट्राइंग टू एस्केप फ्रॉम दैट. अब कमिंग टू द लिटरेरी डिवाइसेस, एज वी हैव कम्प्लीटेड द पोम, एज वी हैव मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम सीन दैट एवरी पोम हैज़ द राइमिंग स्कीम, बट इन दिस पोम राइमिंग स्कीम इज एब्सेंट, दैट मीन्स इट इज रिटन इन फ्री वर्ड्स. एलिट्रेशन इज द रेपिटेशन ऑफ अ कॉन्सोनेंट वर्ड, कॉन्सोनेंट साउंड. जहाँ आया था ही इज हार्मलेस स्नेक, तो एच एच का बार बार ये कॉन्सोनेंट है, इसका रेपिटेशन आ रही है, तो दैट इज द एलिट्रेशन. Now coming to the summary of the poem, the poet says that the snake is harmless even to children. Poet क्या बताते हैं हमें कि snake, जिस snake को chase किया जा रहा था, that snake was harmless even to children. People fear snakes and when they see one, they try to kill it with a stick. लोग snake से डरते हैं और जैसे वो snakes को देखते हैं, उनको ऐसा लगता है that they have to kill the snake because so that it don't harm anyone. The snake tries to save itself and hides behind the green colored bushes of marshy plants growing in the water. In order to save himself, agar even snakes ko apni jaan ki parwah hoti hai, to protect himself from that stick, the snake was trying a lot to hide himself. Firstly, wo water mein gaya tha snake. Then after that, he was lying in sand until anybody saw him, and when somebody saw him again, it went to the thick marshy plants aur wahan jaake wo pani ke andar chup gaya tha. Okay students, I hope this poem is clear to you, and yes, of course this poem gives us a message that we must not kill animals, and we must in fact not only kill, हमें इनफैक्ट एनिमल्स को परेशान ही नहीं करना चाहिए. वी मस्ट लेट देम डू व्हाट दे वांट टू डू, लेट देम वॉक फ्रीली. दे इवन वी एज ह्यूमन बींग्स, इफ वी हैव द फ्रीडम फॉर एवरीथिंग, सो एज आर एनिमल्स, इवन दे मस्ट हैव द फ्रीडम टू वॉक, दे मस्ट हैव द फ्रीडम टू गो एनीवेयर, एंड वी मस्ट नॉट किल देम बिकॉज दे डोंट हार्म अस. आई होप स्टूडेंट्स दिस पोएम इज clear to you, and of course you got a message from this poem, and I hope that this message, you are going to obey this message. Thank you.